that really help them secure.
Inside the Center for Virus Research at the Kenya Medical Research Institute, scientists are using new tools that are transforming how the country detects and responds to viral diseases. Until recently, sequencing of polioviruses had been done in South Africa or at the U.S. Center for Disease Control and Prevention in Atlanta, causing long delays in confirming results, hampering surveillance, and slowing outbreak response.
We used to collect samples from the field, and then we do cell culture. And then after cell culture, we look for changes in the culture of the cultures, and then after that, we determine whether the sample is positive or negative for polio. After that, we advanced and started doing what we refer to as ELISA tests and other tests that help to check for the presence of the viruses.
With the new sequencing technology, scientists can now read the genetic code of viruses in just 7 to 10 days, making it easier to detect and confront outbreaks quickly.
And be able to differentiate if it is a wild type of poliovirus, vaccine-derived poliovirus, or any new virus that may be emerging out there, because these viruses have ability to reassort themselves and also to change genetically, what we refer to as mutations. And with these mutations, they are able to cause disease that will affect human beings.
Health Cabinet Secretary Adendo Ale, who led the inauguration, described the facility as a key milestone in advancing Kenya's Taifa Care model and compliance with international health regulations. He added that the laboratory will benefit not only Kenya, but also neighboring countries.
Strong disease surveillance and local diagnostic capacity are critical to the universal health coverage. Why do I say so? They will ensure protection from outbreaks, and they will enable us to act fast, efficient, and cost-effective responses. This expanded polio laboratory contributes directly to our agenda as a country.
According to KEMRI's Acting Director General, Professor Elijah Songok, while anchored in polio eradication, it is designed to serve as a multi-pathogen genomic platform, already sequencing mpox, measles, rubella, and enteric viruses.
If you are able to read the genomic structure of that virus and what we call as sequencing, that is what now tells us that this virus has this capacity and is different from another virus, and it has either mutated or is similar to the virus of origin.
The lab that was supported by the World Health Organization and the Gates Foundation will serve both as a Kenya's national reference laboratory and as an inter-country reference laboratory for Somalia, Djibouti, Eritrea, and the Comoros. Emily Chebet, Citizen TV.